ضربوا المعالي دربهم لم يسلكوا دربا سواه فدربهم درب دعاء
تبعوا سبيل المصطفى الهادي الأمين خير الخلائق.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه وأحبابه إلى يوم الدين. My dear brother and sister, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Today I would like to speak in my reminder about the rights, al-huquq. We always speak about the rights, belong to who, and where is my rights, where is my rights. First, we have to understand the main rights that we should look for it, Allah's rights. حقوق الله عز وجل حق الله علينا. And we should work very hard for these rights. And I'm going to speak about the other rights, like the family's rights, husband and wife, and Rasulullah SAW after that, after Allah's rights. And I will speak about the kids' rights and other rights, inshallah, if we will continue, inshallah, after Ramadan in the daily reminder. Allah's rights being described in the Quran and Sunnah. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا. And many ayahs, and you can see all the Quran speak about the Allah's rights and the Prophet's rights and what's your rights and what's the mankind's and the human beings and the neighbor's rights. Ibadatullah Azza wa Jal التي من أجلها خلقنا وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. Allah create us and create the jinn to worship him. And Allah writes that to worship him without any partner and to make everything clear and pure to him alone. من عمل عملا أشرك معي غيري تركته وشركه. If you do anything and you have a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will leave this thing and leave you to the partner. And you will gain zero then. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us and all of us away from that. Allah writes in the Quran that Allah said in many ayah that you should worship him alone. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he write down that you worship him alone, without any partners. And the whole Quran, it's been based on worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي. Everything in my life belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for him alone. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Sunnah, he was riding with Mu'adh ibn Jabal and he told him, أتدري ما حق الله على العباد؟ Oh Mu'adh, do you know what's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rights from his worshipper? You see, Allah wa Rasuluh a'lam. Allah wa Rasuluh a'lam. Allah and his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they knows. He say, حقهم أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا. حق الله على العباد أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا. Allah's rights to worship him alone and to have no partner with him. And then they walk for a while and he asked him again, do you know Mu'adh, what's حق العباد عند الله إذا هم فعلوا ذلك؟ قال الله ورسوله أعلم. Oh Mu'adh, do you know if they do that, what the rights that they can get it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, Allah and his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows. He say, if they do that, أَلَّا يُعَذِّبَ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. If they do that, he will not punish any one of them. What's a great thing that you can gain and you get from Allah? If you worship him alone, and you worship him in the way that he asks you to do it, what you're going to get? You will not be punished. You will not see the hellfire. You will go to the Jannah that we all ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. أسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يجعلنا من الموحدين المخلصين الصادقين وأن لا نشرك به أحدا. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to worship him alone without any partner and to make us having the ibadah in the purest way belong to him and following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على النبي محمد وعلى آله.
المعالي دربهم لم يسلكوا دربا سواه فدربهم.